Hello. Today I'm going to see about teaching you guys the self-closing mock ring. Simple explanation is it's just a chain made to look like a ring. So to start off, you need to know how to chain, first of all. But you're going to want to leave a loop, a space. I'm just using a continuous thread method with just a shuttle and a ball of thread. So, personally, I pinch it where I want it to stop and then slip my finger in so it doesn't, so I can make sure. And so, you want to make sure that your shuttle is on the bottom so that you're chaining right. So, I'm going to chain 5. I'm going to chain 5. Pico. Make a pico, and then 5 more double stitches. 4, 5. And then we can go ahead and do another pico, and then 5 more, just to kind of make it look good. So, the situation that we have now is we have the ball thread up here, the shuttle thread, the loop, and the chain. And so what you do to make this a self-closing mock ring is you put the shuttle through the chain straight. So make sure the loop isn't twisted or anything. This really isn't twisted. You can see when you straighten it out, it's nice and straight. So you hold your stitches and you keep pulling until it's closed. And so you have a chain that's made to seem as if it's a ring.